Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to cover how to set up an S3 data lake destination in Fivetran. Additionally, we will sync data from an on-prem SQL Server database and explore it using Athena. We begin with our connector dashboard, where we can see all of our active connectors and destinations. As we navigate to destinations and click on Add Destination, we're prompted to enter our destination name, which we will call S3 Iceberg. In addition to data lake destinations, Fivetran offers multiple data warehouse destinations. However, in our case, we'll focus on S3 data lake. On the right-hand side, you'll notice our setup guide integrated into the setup form. This guide contains all the necessary steps to configure our destination. We have already completed the setup instructions, so we simply need to populate the setup form with our bucket name, an IAM role, specially created for Fivetran with access to the bucket, a prefix path to load data into a specific directory, and the bucket's region. The external ID you see here is used in the trust policy for the IAM role, ensuring that only Fivetran can utilize that role to access the bucket. We support the use of private link for additional security. Keep in mind that your S3 bucket needs to be in the same region as Fivetran. Fivetran has the ability to deliver data to S3 in either Iceberg or Delta format, depending on your needs. This can be selected in our setup form. Fivetran uses AWS Glue to handle all the metadata. Fivetran can deploy infrastructure that aligns with your data processing location of choice. We also offer the choice of cloud service provider, AWS, Azure, or GCP, and specific regions within those cloud service providers. Keep in mind that this does not need to match your specific cloud, processing location, or region. It simply tells Fivetran where you want it to deploy infrastructure, which can be changed based on your data residency requirements. As mentioned earlier, all the necessary steps to configure bucket permissions, IAM roles, and trust relationships in AWS are found in our setup guide on the right-hand side. Now we are going to save and test our connector, which will check that we have configured our access and permissions correctly. After successfully confirming everything is set up correctly, we'll add our source connector. In this case, we've chosen an on-prem SQL Server database that contains data about various industries. We've already completed our prerequisite setup on our SQL Server instance, so we'll proceed with filling out the setup form. Just like our S3 destination, we have a setup guide on the right-hand side that covers how to configure the SQL Server database for replication. Again, we will click Save and Test and let Fivetran run through the setup test to confirm if we have configured our database correctly. And we can see that we have several schemas and tables that Fivetran has been granted access to. We will select Allow All to sync any and all future schema changes. And lastly, we will start our initial sync. After some time has passed, we can see on the dashboard that our SQL Server sync completed in a few minutes, and we can see how much data was brought over. Let's move over to our AWS environment and look at the landed data. We will navigate to our ts-s3-destination-demo bucket and find the datalake_demo directory. As we enter this directory, you can see that each of our schemas from the SQL Server database has successfully landed in S3. Note they are prefixed with the name of the connector to avoid collisions between different connectors syncing into the same directory. Let's dive into our agriculture schema and look at some wine production data. We can see data and metadata folders that are part of the Iceberg structure. And if we click into these folders, we can see the underlying data in Parquet format. Next, we'll move over to AWS Glue, where we've registered our schemas and tables with a Glue metastore. We can filter our databases to the industry database we loaded, and we can see the same schemas we saw in S3. If we expand the location of our California wine production data, we can see the link to the S3 location we were just in. If we click into the table, we can see all the associated column definitions. Now we are here in Athena, we can natively query our AWS data catalog and use it to query the California wine production data we loaded using SQL. In a few quick seconds, our query completes and we are able to see our results. Now, if we want to take this a step further, we can use a BI tool to connect to Athena, which will serve as a query engine, which we can then use to visualize our data.